You know how to whistle, don't you, Steve? You just put your lips together and blow.
Did you see yourself the way you were described? Did you see yourself as sultry, sexual?
No.
You did not. You were a little Jewish girl from New York? How did you see yourself?
Things never change. I don't see myself. I don't understand that kind of thing. I don't think that way. I really do have not put myself in a category. God knows enough other people put us all in categories, and I hate that. I was playing a game, you know, it's play acting. Anyway, when you're a kid, when you're starting, and I was very young, and I don't think of myself as anything I would like to be thought of as an actress. That's all I ever wanted to be thought of as a good one.
Next thing you've got to remember is that a gentleman you meet among the cold cuts is simply not as attractive as one that you meet, say, in the meat department at Bergdorf's.
I try not to look too closely, actually, because it doesn't interest me to go back into the past. I really don't live in the past at all. And I just think that I've had a very lucky life in many ways, and I've had a hard life in some ways, and I've had a very up and down life. It has certainly not been on an even keel at all.
You have no intention of not working.
You are correct.
Why?
I love to work, and I live alone. In New York. I have three grown children who have their own lives. I have got to have a life of my own. I cannot depend on my children. Yes, but I am not your typical one. I do not babysit. That's not my function.
You don't do windows.
No, I don't do windows.
You don't babysit? You don't take the little ones home and diaper them? No.
Please. I've done that with my own three kids.
So forget it.
I was not put on earth for that.
Are you a good mother-in-law?
I love them. I don't know. I hope so. I mean, that's not a...
You don't interfere.
It's not a profession. Oh, I interfere sometimes because I have opinions, as you may have noticed.
So you want to keep on working.
But I have to keep on working because I love to work. And I think one must use oneself. And it keeps my brain going. It keeps me physically functioning and trying to keep in some kind of shape. And it's what I trained to do, and I don't believe in retiring.
It's an awful thing to do to a woman my age. Leave her alone with her thoughts.
I don't like legend. I mean, I don't like the category, and to begin with, to me, a legend is something that is not on the earth, that is dead.
You have to be dead to be a legend.
I think so. Because legends are built and evolved in the past. They're not the present. And I don't like categories either, in any event. I prefer individual. I mean, if people have respect for you or admire your work or whatever, I mean, it's like they say, this one is the second Garbo, that one is the second Bogart, this is the second. There are no seconds. You are what you are. Everyone is an individual.
How about the term living legend?
I don't like legend, Larry.
No matter what, living
I legend. Don't like legend. I don't know what it means.
What part of your life, of a star's life, is my business?
I think my work is your business, and I think perhaps what I do in public, but nothing that I do in private is your business.
Nothing.
Nothing. We have no protection, it seems to me, in this country when it comes to invasion of privacy. Yeah.
It's open sesame.
And I think that is a horror. Yeah.
And you are an angel.
And you're almost one.